Hello everyone, good afternoon. Welcome to Artisan Studio. This is Anuja and today we are going to work on how to make Kalamkari faces in Kalamkari. So we will work on different types of faces, how to make it, what are the proportions and other details, how to give it a Kalamkari look. Good afternoon, everyone. If you are able to see me and hear me, then please type a yes so that we can start with our workshop. Thank you so much. Wish you a very happy Onam today and the Raksha Bandhan tomorrow. Yeah, the festivals have started and we'll gear up with that. Hello, everyone. So just checking the audio and the video, waiting for a yes from someone. Okay, Jyoti, great. Okay. So for today's tutorial is going to be giving you a wide variety of faces. How do we do faces? What are the different types of face that we can do? What are the small changes that will give a lot of variation in the face type? So suppose we do a different kind of eye, the expression of the eye. It looks like it is the same, but it never is. So for the woman, for the male, for the female, for the gods, there is a different kind of eye. The chin, the decoration, their crown, the mukut, that all varies, and how to make a normal human being like musicians and all. So when we study the humans in Kalamkari, we see that they can be very simple as well with less ornamentation. If we go to the goddess, if you see the god pictures, they are more ornamental and they have lots of detailing and lots of jewelry. That makes it even more complex and beautiful also. But when we go on a very simple picture or complex, the main structure of the face or the body stays the same. So it goes as the human form of God is the idol. And then we just make those idols in the Kalamkari form. So no matter how we take the gods and how we make the present the normal human, it is only the limbs, the hands. They will have many hands, they will have different weapons, they will have different mudras, and few of the gods, they have different forms, and the forms are from birds, animals. These are also there. Like if we do Ganesha, a different perspective is there. If we do Narsimha, a different perspective is there. So while we are doing the gods, it is very important for us to know the body form, the body form of a human, and the face form of the respective animals or the forms of whatever bird, animal or any other avatar they might have. So these are few things that we have to keep in mind when we do the gods. So today in our class today and tomorrow, we will talk about a brief perspective of how to make different forms. What should be the proportions? So tomorrow I have a planned class, but I'm not going to disclose this today. Today we will be studying about various kinds of faces that are there. Some meditative faces when the eyes are closed, when open, and different forms, different types of chins, different face eyes, and different headgears, and how we can do a little variation in the decorations. When we see the pictures, we see that mostly people come up with saying that it all looks the same, but it is not the same. It is not the same. Even every artist, if we follow Kalamkari in a Sri Kalahasti form, every artist who is doing a freehand pen drawing will have their own forte and will have their own style of doing it. The same goes for Tanjore. The Tanjore has one basic form. Everybody falls into that. But the way the eyes and the face are made, it depends on the artist who is doing a Tanjore also. So in Kalamkari also, it depends on the Sri Kalahasti style. It is not a block printing, whereas Machilipatnam is a block printing. So a block is created and then it is stenciled on the cloth. And you will see different blocks, different blocks in different colors, but the main outline will be the same. That is the Machilipatnam style. When we draw the Sri Kalahasti, we see the fabrics with lengths and lengths with telling the stories. Not one human form will be repeated. So if it is a normal scenario of a wedding or a procession legends or the stories from Ramayana and Mahabharata, not two figures will be the same. That is when the innovation comes. That is when the mudras, the forms, the postures, they play a lot of vital role in that. So Sri Kalahasti style is a very free hand style where the art is more dependent on the person who is doing it, and every form will be different, every picture will be different. One artist, even if they recreate their picture, if it is a free hand and not stenciled and measured, it will be varying from the previous one. So this variation is always seen, and today we will start with normal study as to understanding the picture. How do we understand the Kalamkari form and the faces, not just copying it? Because copying is very, we do get those who are, those who might feel that it is very difficult and I'm not getting it, they might always take the help of the prints that are available online, and they can Xerox it, they can copy it and trace it and transfer it to the picture they want to do. But if in case we want to follow the Sri Kalahasti style, we want to do the freehand, then we have to know the basic things where we can separate each form and each face slightly different from the other. So I will place my camera on my workplace and we will start the drawing. I'm taking a normal paper A4 size because today is just the drawing and understanding thing. Tomorrow we will do a full-fledged idol. So let's get started. Any question that anybody has, please share right now. So normal paper, any paper is okay because today it is the study of variations. You can practice it. And later tomorrow we will be doing a full idol. Good afternoon, everyone. Please feel welcomed. I cannot just mention everybody's name, but yes, you are so dear to me. You take out time every weekend at 3 o'clock. To see me and be a part of the learning and sharing thing from Arthral Studio. Okay. So just a pen. If today I'm just taking a normal pen because I might not be coloring. Here it is a waterproof pen. I just go for a waterproof pen. I will be taking a pencil also just to give the drafting of a little proportions that will be easy for you to follow. If you have not subscribed the channel, please hit on the subscribe button. And if you like the video, do not hesitate, share, hit a like and share the videos. So here, let's get started. So I am taking an A4 size paper and pencil and a pen. So pen is something that we will be using later. To start with, I'm taking a pencil. How do we figure out the face? So the faces can be small or big, depends on what size you want it to be. Here I'm making a reasonably bigger size and I am dividing the half, that is the zone that divides the nose, the lips, and that forms the symmetry of the face. So this is one straight line that will mark that the face is here, and we often just make it with a circle. So circle, when I say circle, you will feel that few of the faces are not exactly full circle. They will be slightly oval, and then you can add that thing to the face. So here, roughly giving it a slight oval, maybe if I can say, like this, this shape. And then, how would you measure where is what? So we divide the face into two halves here. And this is where the eye is. Even if we look at our faces, eye is the line that divides the face into two halves. So the same anatomy goes on that. And here I am just marking the jewelry that plays a vital role. So you have to just check that both the circles are equal. They might get a little cut or full depending on the angle of the picture. So if the angle of the face is slightly bent on the other side, then this will be hidden and this will be full. So that is one thing, but right now I'm doing the front face and giving it the full form. Here, this. Now, going over here, giving the top gear, I'm just making the two circles here full circles. Just make a couple of lines and then you will just give it a circle so that you feel that, okay, now it's perfect. Leave it. Here is the place where the ears will come, and the ears come like this. I'm giving a space because my ornamentation will have frills here. This is a very rough plotting of it. This is the place for the ear. This is the place for the headgear. Now we'll be curving it and then we can just top it with another one. Yet another one. You'll see that the circles decrease on this side, and this is a normal form of the picture. So rough, very rough. This is the face. Now how do we give a full and the final look? We will start. The facial features will be added, and since this is the center, the nose will be plotted here. I'm giving a very rough look to this right now, so just a block for checking the nose. Here are the lips and here will be the eyes. So that's it. Now we will start with the design of with pen. So here when everything is plotted, we see that the outline of the face is somewhere overlapping, right? So here the ornamentation, we will start the first. This. You may add thin or long frills like this. This is one feature that is seen in most of the Kalamkari pictures. The edge is curved. This. I'm attaching it to the ear. Doing it on the other side as well. You may draw this freehand, and you may just have that. Don't be very calculative on how many curves you are making on the one and the other. It goes freehand. We are making Rishit. We are making the face study today, and tomorrow we will do the full idol. So today it is just the face study of various forms. So, like this. So this is the karnaphool or the earring. The ears. Now we see that the chin is all rounded and shows very clearly. This. Going to the side of the face, and now we will start building the design on the top. Now the face gets partially covered here, so we are not extending the line. We'll do the same on this other side. Like this. This portion is done. So it's kind of taking shape on here. Now, giving the forehead. We'll do a couple of lines. Now this is the second one. The view of the face changes totally when we see the side view. So this is just the front one. This is only one deep cut. So when we do the face, it is very important what is the proportion. Sometimes we see that the head, mukut or whatever the decoration on the head is, maybe a slightly smaller than the face or equal. So that is there. For there are a few gods and goddesses, depending on the wish and the adorning that you want to do, you may get take a higher mukut. So for the mukut, these are very important. Generally, we see in Kalamkari that these three are already there. We have different forms and shapes of mukut as well. This is a very common one. It depends. Definitely the mukut has to go high. It can have a steep or a rounded or a rectangle. Depends on the design, what you want to keep it. Now I'm connecting the third band here. These bands will go like a big one, the small and the smaller, and then we will make the final tip of it. Now this is a very common, and we will see this lotus form in many of the gods and goddesses. So it's not that the crown is only for the gods and goddesses. Sometimes we make the Raja, the Rani, the Sita, Ram, Dashrath, or any other mythical character, and we will see this. There is one more thing that is added, and that is the center or the top. So this is ready. Now we will go on the center of the face. How do we work on that? Now, this is done And how, if we go on the chin part, I will show you the variation of the chin part in a different paper. Here first we have to do the eye. So we take the center, we plot the eye. You have to see that both the eyes stand the same. The angle of it should be same. And just a fish like that. Now this corner shows that the lashes are big. You might not add it or add it, depends on which figure you're doing. How would you decide it? If you're doing males and all, we might not do that. Here. Now the eyelids are added like this. And the whatever tikka, a bindi, a tikka, whatever has to be done is here. Now, we see the eyeballs, the study of the eyeball is a. Yes, we will do that, Arush, don't worry. So, we'll do different forms. This is a front face right now. And this is the eye. You have to check whether the eye is of the same size or not. And we do the full black. If in case you want to add a little shine dot, you may add a little shine dot. And then the coloring goes. Just adding this slight dot gives a very good effect to the picture. So this looks as if it is really lively. In some which are not very detailed, you might see that the whole thing is black. This. Now, time to add the eyebrow. Just give it a beautiful curve. This one. A bindi. Now comes the head. Now hair can be very curved or small, or it can be like this. We give a cut here and this. The ornamentation is totally your wish. You can also add a tikka. That is purely your imagination or this. Whatever color you want to add for this. The nose definitely come in the center and we go thin. The noses are thin and we give the center line to the nose. We give the nostrils and the center of the nose has a tip. It's a very simple one. For the face, we go, this is a straight cut that I showed where we are plotting. But when we do a smiling figure, we just add a smiley like we do it in our emoji smiley. Very simple. And then we just add the cupid's bow or the center of the lip. So this part, it's already looking that the picture is smiling. The lower lip is a very soft and very thick part here like this. And this gives a beautiful picture of a face. This is definitely a female face. How do we do the decorations on this face? We can go a little more elaborate and add more design to it. So this is a normal face. If you do not want to do it very heavy, you can keep it like that. If you want to do more onto this, you may add the nose ring. It totally gives a very feminine look and very soft. So here I'm just adding the details like this. Yeah. So this gives one picture. Now here, how do we go beyond this point? We just do add a little bit of the chin over here and give this curve. That is the neck portion. And even if it is a Machilipatnam style or a stencil, generally the faces, they start with the mukut, the face, and the neck, and whatever the neck piece is. So here we are going to do the neck piece. You can go elaborate or less, depends on how you want to do it. Thank you for your blessings, Pavan. It's yes, I was not able to read all of them. Thank you. You're liking it so much. I'm so thankful to you. Yes. Male and a female. I will be talking about male. We will do a couple of them and then probably the understanding will be better. This here is a female, and because obviously a nose, nut and a tika, there are different various types of tika that goes for males and females, so it's a different form, and sometimes the mukut formation also changes for the male. So we'll work on that, and our study will be a little more on this. Now here on the neck we can add, now this is the patent style that's there anyway, so we're just adding it like this. Centerpiece, I'll just add a little more. So generally when I start it with the center so that this falls in the same line. And if you remember, I added this line to get the tip of the crown, the tika, the nose, the lip and the centerpiece all aligned very well. So this is one basic line that you would want to do. Also, Rekha, thank you so much. And here, this, we can go elaborate and do it even more heavy. There is no end to that actually, but so if you want to do it a little more, we can have a little more over here and then we can stop. So I'm just giving you the idea. Now after doing this, you will get the full idea of how much more you can do. So this is very basic here. Probably if I add this kind of a curve, that is one more detail. Then if I add one more curve like this where the hair is coming, that is another detail. So those things can be added. It depends on how you want to keep your picture. So I'll just, now this is what basic is. Now I'm just doing something extra so that you have the liberty of raising your bar a little. Thank you, Karnam. Thank you. Now here also, we can add those. Generally, we see these kind for males and females both. So this is something. So depends on how much more you want to go and do your work. Okay, so this is there. Now, one more variation is there. In the chin, I will be showing, we can also leave the chin like this and we can also beautify it in a different way. Adding it a small curve will give it a little more beauty. Now this is a type of chin that we can have. We can have many types. I will be sharing how many types of chins we can do, how many types of noses we can do. Okay, so this is pretty much, and since we have done it, I would love to do a little hair so that it gives a better look. So just you may just do it directly with the paint. I have pen handy right now, so I'm just filling it up. So one I'll show you with the filling, because and then later we might not fill actually. This may be colored or this may be kept like black and white. It's all your wish. This is the picture. Sometimes we see that small flower tattoos are done on the cheeks or the chin. That is okay. Now here, see. You will see that when you will see the picture, you will see one dot or one line will make a lot of difference. Right? Now we will go ahead with another face, and I will be doing. I don't think I have much place here to do a face. I'll just go a little low. So I hope everybody has done this, and I'll just move a little low and do one more over here. So giving it a small, okay, just giving you a small variation of a face over here. So what if I want some face where, like when I'm doing a Krishna picture and the kids, like a baby Krishna, is with the friends and they are hiding from Maya Yashoda. Just imagine that scene and how it will be. It will not be that they are open in open to be seen. They are hiding some places. How would we do that? So here I am just making the same face a little slight like this, more curved this time. And this is something that I do all the time. I do it with a pencil, just the basic line that I feel it comes handy. And this is the place where I will be plotting my. This is the nose and this is the lip. So this is one form of just a half of the face. We'll go ahead and do a small Krishna face hiding. So baby Krishna, how would we do that? So here again, so only this much, and I will just go on the sides to make the design. I'll add a few different designs now so that you get variety. So this is a little pointed curves, very slight changes you can make. And then again, just fringing it out a little. This. Doing the ear. Then again, the side here, as we did on this side. I'm just replicating one side and not the symmetry because I will be hiding it from the other side. This the second now here there's a slight variation you would see. I hope I'm just doing the half. I'm not making the full curve, so it is like kind of sticking to each other. And not like this, so it's a small variation. Like this. Now, assuming I have something here and I would rather try to make it, so I'm just making this side of the face slight, so this part is covered. Let's see how about it, this one. With the side bun, it's easier for to do it for Krishna. I don't remember the name, but somebody asked the side bun, so probably this would help you out. Here, we may also add flowers, the lotus. Lotus here. I'm adding the. the tiers, or probably it's a three-tier thing that it is being worn here. And in case we want to add the side, not too much of the mukut, just open. We'll do it one by one, we cannot do it right away. So here, this is the face center, and just taking the center, and here I don't have the earring. I have the earring. So we'll just mark the nose. I'm marking the nose here. Straight line. Like this. Now, definitely I'm not adding anything to the nose. And a very cute smiling face. Now for the chin, we can add a very nice dimpled chin, and that is the how we do the chin form here. That's one very small detail here. When we do not want to add too many layers or the mukut, if we are doing a bal gopal or a smaller version, how would we do that? So keep the center. And this. Now, partially this place is also visible, so I'll just do the part of this one as well. And how to go about the side bun. So I'm adding this peacock feather that was very dear. And this is the side bun here. We can add the beads. Now what else can be added here is a small tassel. So tassel or whatever the cloth is hung. So these things are totally on your imagination, but you have to follow the only the ways that are prevalent in this style. So here I will be adding the neck band or whatever the So if you want to add a full face, black or blue, you may do it black also, you may do it blue also, that is totally okay. You may do it gray also. So, generally it is done blue, but yes, we do it black also. And often we see that there are polka dots or any print that is done. So this is one form of a hiding, whatever it is. So these two forms, these are not very basic. Definitely the ornamentation is high. Now I will be telling, if you want to create a scene, how will you go on the other ones? When we do gods and goddesses, we see that there is a chakra or the halo or the aura that comes out. And that is very simple. We just see that we add one circle and then we do the ornamentation on that also. That is the aura or halo, we call it. So that also. Kerala mural workshop, do sometime later. Yes, of course. Why not? Okay, so this. Now we are now I will be telling you a very different kind of a face, how to male faces also will do, but now today we are doing a very meditative face, how to make a meditative face. Now again, coming back to my thing, I'm making a circle over here. So I hope it's visible. Circle, I extend the circle, not exactly a circle, I just extend a little draw here. So it's kind of a little stretched, it's oval like an egg shape. So that is done. I plot myself the eyes and the center that will just not disturb the picture. So only that much of it I feel that helps a lot. That much here. No, it's okay. I'm holding it in the other way and it is coming down. So here I'll just straighten to my angle. So this. Now I'm going to create a picture and then probably you can guess what it is. I will make the eyebrows. Eyebrows will be very shant and very meditative. So we do not give any curve which is too high angle. It is like a s curve over here, very perfect curve. Now always, most of the time, the challenge comes that only one comes one way and the other doesn't. So in that case, you can take help of a pencil and then try doing it. So here. So these are two curves. No ornamentation here because it is a very different picture. Now I am doing a bowl kind of a eye. So bowl as in it's closed eye. It's half closed, meditative eye or dhyan, whatever is. So I just did it like that. Yes, exactly. It's Buddha. And here, when we do the lower portion, we just do it very slight here. And the lotus, like lotus, the like this. The center line is a little goes up, down, and a half open. So this kind of a eye, and then we do the eyeballs. Eyeballs will be partially seen, and you can do it full black. Now eyelid, just one line for the eyelid. The nose again comes straight. Nose, nostril here. And now again, a very shant, not very shant, very quiet lip. This. So So this is a very, this is just the feature part of it. Now I'm adding the side of the face and doing the ear. So whenever we make the ear, in general also, our ear starts from the eye level and stops at the nose level. So this is the general face for any of the human. You will see that the ear will end here. If you are doing gods and goddesses, the thing will change because then if it's you are doing Ganesha, definitely the ear will be big. If you are doing any avatar, or then the ear will be small, like as I said, Narsimha, the ears will change. But in a human form, the ear generally falls into this. If we see Gautam Buddha had very long ears. So that is one feature that we see Buddha as. So we'll just add the side of the face. And then I'll continue because there's no ornamentation much. I'll just continue with the face and the chin. This over here. So this giving a curve on the face a little, and then it'll go a little down like this. Very big earlobe. I'm doing the same on the other side. Now the hair part comes, and how will be the hair? The hair is all curled up. So I'm just giving the a little detail on this ear because the picture is really, really blank and a very broad neck. Not too many flowers, not too many things. Now, if you do not make this, we see that this can be a form of any of the gods, like half closed eyes. It can be of any meditative form. And now here I'm adding the, not very ornamental, because then definitely Buddha was very simple and has to be very simple. Just adding a little of this. Now I'm just adding the curls. You will see that the curls will go in the same form, in the like the hairline. Just follow the hairline and make these curves. And then we will top it just in the middle of it. You can draw any picture, any form in Kalamkari style, whichever you want to. So it is not that only one or two gods you can make. You can make any picture in any form. It is just that you have to get into the form. Now, if in case you feel that you might go wrong, you take the height of how much you want it. So just get to the center so that, like we did it for this one, the top, and it should match. Definitely the center bun should be matching. Just plot yourself like in a way where you want to balance it and see how it is coming. And this pretty much, that is what. And that is how I'm following the same line here. And this will help us to get the form. Now I will be adding this. Few small, few big, that's totally okay. We don't have to be very calculative about it. Just filling in with the curves. If in case you feel that you have to balance like one over here, you may balance and just give it a side also a little. This we might want to add a tikka if in case, generally if it's like a bindi, whatever your wish is to give it. I'll give it a oval over here, and this is pretty much giving it a little sides, and that this finishes the picture. Now when we do this as a manly form, then here I can add different types. I will erase and I'll be showing it to you. So here what variations you can do it on the chin is, you may just do it like this. This is one form. The next is, you may want to do it like this, where your lips are over here. The second one, you may want to do another one, which is I'm just giving it a lips over here. You might just curve it down. This is here, this is here. Sometimes we do it like this. For males, when we do, we might just want to do it. Totally depends on which form you want to do it. Yes, we'll do it. Can we draw Ganesh in Kalamkari? Yes, there are a lot many things, n number of things that can be done. Today is just a face history, face study, and how to make different kinds of face, different forms, and you can do many things on it. So this is here. I will be showing you others. How to make sages. Sages like Rishi and the Muni. How to do that? How to make gods, specific gods, we'll do it tomorrow. And how to make different faces, we'll just go ahead and tell you a few of them. Shivji, yes, of course. I'll keep it in mind. I'll plant one full idol on Shivji. So here, when we are doing a face again, and this is the Hanuman or the monkey god. So now here I'm not adding the oval, it's rounded because the form of that is like this. So just one circle, and now I will start. So now I'm just giving you the forms of the faces, and not a very detailed one, so that you get the main feature of the face, and the detailing is, I hope you can catch up on the detailing because we've already done highly detailed pictures on here. Okay, so we are adding this, adding the sides. Doing the ear. Now just the curve of it. We may also do it like this. Just giving you a rough idea of how it is, because our main study will go on the face. So just giving a small outline of it. Mm-hmm. Now here I'm making the sides. I'll make the tikka. Now I've not cut the whole thing in the center. You can see the difference of adding not a dot and adding a dot makes a difference. I have added the dot for the others. Now eyelids, the nose formation changes, and here it is a little broad one, flat one, and then from there on we will have this shape. And the lower portion will just be a little hanging like this. So this way you can add a little bit of the lower portion. For the shoulders, we will just, since I've made shoulders, I'll give you the idea of how it is. We will do this more elaborately when we'll do the full idol on how to work on the decorations on throughout the body of the god. How would we do that? This. So today we have gone through the faces of how to make the front face formation is just like this. Depending on how we are making the males and the females, we might add a mustache and a beard, which we'll talk about in the next class, in the next session, because there are a lot of faces. I've got the request for telling how the Shiva is. I will plan a class tomorrow. We will be doing the Ganesha as told. We'll see which one. And just be ready and be in the session and work with me. Any other thing that you want, how to work on any of the gods and goddesses, you can write up to me and I'll try to figure out and give a session for you. Okay, so this is a very simple. We see a lot of fabrics having the stencils of Buddha. So that can be created as Machilipatnam style. You may also do it as one Buddha and create and just paint it. Now painting can be done on the face also and outside the face also, wherein we just keep the face as white or the base color of the paper, and then we just do the background in different colors and we post and we place it. So these kind of pictures, even the smaller ones, if you do and just decorate it as a corner and do it on the coasters or anything, or fridge magnets, they look amazing, amazing. So just take a small one and MDF board or a small plastic cover or a lid of any jar, anything you can take, and just see if you can fit a face on that. And yes, and then when you can do the painting, you can paint it with the acrylic pen drawing, and acrylic sides you can paint with acrylic paint, and then just put a magnet and place it on your fridge or wherever you want it. Sure, I will be taking up Krishna also, and we will be doing the Ganesha also, because those are the upcoming festivals, so we will just do that. Oh, the list is getting more. Now Durga, Ganesha, then Shiva, the lot. I'll try to do a few very prominent ones, the ones who the winds which have different features altogether. So different features. Probably when we do the Durga face will be just a feminine face with the limbs added. Limbs, adding of the limbs, we will work in many of the gods, and adding of the limbs and the vajras, whatever the weapons they carry, will only give the vibe of the god or the goddess. So today we did the female faces, and this female face can be apt for many of the female goddesses. It only mostly depends on the these are impressions, like the impressions and the line drawings that help you symbolize the god. So if you add the same face and put it as Durga, if you want to the same as Var, Lakshmi, anything that you want to add, you may just take the basic symbols and put it around, and then you will be able to do it. Yes, it's Hanuman. It's the monkey face god. Yes. So these are the pictures that we did today, and I hope you all liked it. And if you have liked it, press the hit button, like, and do let me know in the comments. And it will be posted on the channel. If you want to work on this, please do and share it with me on my Facebook page. And anything else, you please write it to me in the chat box, and I will answer to you all. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for your time and being with me. I'll see you all tomorrow. Tomorrow at the same time, 3 o'clock, we will do a full item. So be prepared. Thank you, everyone.